My name is Andreas Greiner. I'm an artist based in Berlin, and I deal with the boundary between nature and art. Or I try to dissolve the boundaries between technology, art, and nature. Any technological tool can help to improve things or to make things easier, but it can also be very destructive. So I think my emphasis as an artist is also on researching how to use technology to improve things. Since 2017, 18, I've been taking pictures in different types of forests, and I've been creating picture archives with many 10,000s of images, which I then feed to machine learning or artificial intelligence algorithms. And with this project, I've been actually exploring the potential of artificial intelligence and trying to research about its gaze onto nature. I kind of thought I should go and revisit the question of landscape painting from the Romantic era. Of course, AI can replace an artist. I think anything can replace the artist. I think in the 21st century, we should get rid of the idea of the artist being a genius and the artist being something very special. For the moment, AI is probably rather a tool, but if it ever gains autonomy, if it ever kind of gets to the stage where it can be creative, why shouldn't it be an artist? Creativity is not a thing that is limited to humans only. What I tried to research with the work Mars and Earth was to kind of like demystify the question of carbon compensation. In this work, we calculated the carbon footprint of the money that the US government spent 13 years on the Apollo moon landing project and compared it to the carbon footprint of coal being burned for Germany's electricity consumption in 2018. The very basic question I'm also trying to refer to in this work is as the idea of the exit strategy. So nowadays we have a lot of different ideas of like how to fight climate change and how to advance in this question. And one very popular idea is to fly to Mars to export our ecosystem and have a second planet, as if it was easier to turn Mars into Earth than preventing Earth from being turned into Mars. I think the first step for the art industry to become more ecologically responsible is to be honest to itself, to kind of also stop telling the myth to itself that talking about like ecological issues is enough and is going to lead to different actions. I think the first step is to kind of like really analyze its own actions and then think about them and then see where we can change that. But I think the future for the art world should be, especially for the commercial art world, should be to cut down on its pace. To rediscover the beauty and the joy of doing things slowly, to take time again for art. So less art fairs, less biennials, less traveling, be more thoughtful about the packaging, be more thoughtful about the way things are transported. After my first very big solo exhibition in 2017, I got a grant to fly around the world, and first I was very happy about it, and very soon later I discovered that I'm somehow contradicting myself if I'm giving interviews about the ecological footprint of meat consumption, but then follow the same path like any other artist. The footprint of an artist is not the best. And therefore, the first time I came also across this idea of compensation, and I was looking at all these websites offering tree compensation for flight miles. I just discovered that planting trees is a very beautiful thing, And I decided to plant a tree for each exhibition that I have, or each solo exhibition at least. And yeah, now 3-4 years later, I'm planting trees myself. In 2019, I had a museum exhibition in Goslar, which is a city close to the Harz region in Germany. I co-initiated an NGO in Goslar, which is called Wald für Morgen. And together with Gertrude and Jan Kremse, we initiated a planting project where people plant their own tree and establish a godfather's relationship to the tree, and where also each tree that is being planted has a GPS code and can be monitored over the time. And the project is my biggest outside the White Cube project so far, to go beyond just planting trees, also helping to reinvent the idea of sustainability, but also maybe kind of like reinventing the idea of the forest.